Okay, this is gonna be the basis for my next mod project, and this is the Seiko 5 SNZG13 K1, I guess, if you want to be specific, because the bracelet, I think usually bracelets have a K1. Anyways, yeah, this is a 42 millimeter watch with 22 millimeter lugs. I think the thickness is probably about the same as an SKX, between 12, probably closer to 13, around 13 millimeters or so. You know what? Let's why don't we check it right now? Zero this, and let's pop this off here. I'm not really doing a review on this particular watch, but let's see here. Oh, actually, yeah, just under 12. That's not too bad. It's about 12. Let's just say it's 12. I'm gonna zero it. Is it zeroed? Yeah, close enough. It's gonna be off by like a fraction of a whatever millimeter. It's not that. It's just 12 or just under. Not bad. Turn this off before I forget. And yeah, what I wanted to do with this is a field style watch, relatively inexpensive, but I've been meaning to do something other than an SKX diver, another diver with the SKX as the basis. So this would be a little bit smaller, not as thick, and I wanted to do like a pilot's watch, namely a Flieger, because I couldn't really find a Flieger style watch that I believe was into. I mean, there's so many that's either an A or B dial, but it's classic, and there's some good ones from Stoa and Laco. If you want a real German Flieger with some heritage, that was one of the original five Flieger makers back in World War II. Those are great. You can have them for all sorts of prices. Stova's got customization, all that, to some degree. But I didn't want to do anything that classic, because frankly, they're so classic that they're rather generic. You know, you got one of those versus something that's probably maybe even a lot less expensive, that looks practically identical with the A or B dial, because the case is usually pretty much the same too. You can't tell one from the other. It's not distinctive enough. So I've been looking at some other alternatives. You know, I could go with, instead of the classic A dial, just, you know, the simple three-hander. They have one with a small seconds, which isn't really one from back in those days, as far as I know. It's a newer kind of interpretation of the A dial Fliegers. And there's a one that I've seen that's a very modern B dial with a small seconds from Fortis. It's their, I don't have the exact ref, but I think they call it the cockpit classic small seconds, or small. Oh, it's got small seconds and Aviatis, A-V-I-A-T-I-S. Yeah, 40 millimeters, about 10 millimeters thick. Got a nice lume all around. It's about a grand. It's not, I wouldn't say it's not worth it, but I don't know if I wanted to spend that much for it. And so I just decided in the end. I mean, I saw someone, maybe a couple of people, more than a few people, do this particular watch as a Flieger, and it looks pretty good. I like the fact that I like these indices on the outside here with the, you know, A or B dial, usually a B dial in the middle. I'm more of a fan of B-dial because I like a little bit more detail with that inner hour ring, I guess you could call it, and the outer would be the 60 minutes. Yeah, I don't have all the parts yet, but what's coming in is a B-dial, got some nice lume on it on the outer edge. Doesn't have the inner track, but that's okay. It's from DLW. That I'm still waiting to get in. I think hopefully it'll be in before the in the next couple of weeks, but I've not gotten a shipment notice. I think there's a sale, or they've been closed for about a week, I think, and so they can catch up. But anyways, I hope they get that out soon. And there's two versions you can get and win with and without a day date. And I was gonna do it without at first to keep it more classic B dial style, or you know, Flieger. They don't usually have a day or date, but I wanted to put it in because I didn't want a phantom setting. It's not that big a deal, but I would prefer not to. So, because I'm gonna just reuse this movement, this which I'm gonna talk about in a moment. And so yeah, that way I can still have a day date, which it doesn't look bad with it. They did a pretty good job of keeping it symmetrical and not having too much information, like, you know, missing or offset because of the day date window. The handset I'm getting from Yabokis, and I'm using something that looks like the Zen 104 style, the syringe, which is pretty nice. I don't think I've seen anyone use that style before. And I'm not sure if I'm going to, I might keep the second hand, this one with the stock one that's got the white with the red tip, or I might use this one with the Zen set. You'll see it when I get it. That's incoming. That'll probably come in sooner than the dial. But yeah, I don't know. That's undecided yet. So that's basically it. And two basic parts. I was thinking of upgrading the crystal to a slight dome one, sapphire, but I wanted to keep it flat. And I don't know, I just didn't feel like spending the extra money for it this time. I wanted to keep it under a certain budget. And with my eBay bucks to get this watch and all the parts, of course it wasn't on eBay, but it came in at just under $100 so far. And yeah, I was going to go with I guess it was the other version, the SNZG17. And that has a solid red hand, black dial still, but the case is PVD and a bracelet as well. I can never get a straight answer on it. I think it really is supposed to be gunmetal, but it could be one of the kind of gunmetal colors that looks so dark that a lot of times it looks black, because about half the time it does look black in the photos that I've seen. So, but I was going to do that and then try to weather it, like probably take a Scotch-Brite or something and try to do a weathered look to it, make it look kind of worn, which is kind of a thing that's coming back now. But I didn't want to spend that extra $20, $30 or so more for that. And I couldn't get a confirmation as to what that color was and how hard it would be to possibly sand the surface or weather the surface out of a PVD coated piece. I'm sure it could be done. I just don't know. I don't want to spend too much time really working it. And the trick would be also, if I wanted to get it worked out, then, you know, it'd be hard to make it look, you know, you gotta be careful in doing it so that it doesn't look like a sloppy, like, you know, all these swirl and different, you know, scratch or sanding marks in different directions where it just looks messy. So what I'm going to try to do is stain the stainless steel. There's something that I saw from just did some research that there is some chemicals or some way to apply some patina to this and blacken it, or at least darken it to some degree, depending on how strong the solution is and how long you leave it. And that's what I'm going to attempt to do, is darken this into what I think is a gunmetal color. You know, which is kind of, you know, it's not charcoal, but it's not anthracite either. It's something else. But, it, you know, it's just, if you know gunmetal, it's just a darkened kind of look to silver. It'll have enough of a brightness or sheen to it not to be mistaken for black. At least that's a hope, although I don't botch that up. So, yeah, it's as simple as just spraying it on and then wiping it off, and it should do the trick from what I've seen. How well it lasts, I don't know. I think people could put some sort of spray to really seal it on if you want to protect the finish, but I'm not gonna do that because I kind of wanted to give this an additional worn look over time. So I'm gonna try to darken it, and then I'm gonna carefully take a sanding or file, or probably one of the Scotch-Brite pads that I usually use to polish and add the brush marks if I need to, and wear off the edges and maybe some of the surface, and we'll see how that looks. I was debating whether to try to patina the markers. Could be a pain in the ass. I mean, I don't know how easy it'll be to do a coffee stain or something on all these indices and all the details that would be on a B-dial, and at least the inner loom part of the syringe hands and stuff, just to give it a warmer patina look. I don't know. And if you think about it, you can still have an aged outside without going that aged on the inside, because outside is exposed to the elements, but inside the watch it's covered and it's not really exposed to much. So you really, unless it's really gone old, you shouldn't see like a hell of a lot of things going on the surface of the dial. If you've seen LACO, the way they do their Erbstruck, I don't know, they have a weathered version of their Fliegers. Looks really cool, really beaten down, but looks generally authentic, and it's expensive, but they do it on the inside, like loom is chipped sometimes, and I don't know if you would really get such a battered watch even over time. It looks cool, but since everything's basically sealed underneath the glass, I don't understand why that the dial would be that worn out, unless it's cracked and it's been exposed, and then a brand new crystal's been replaced over all that without cleaning up the dial. But anyways, I don't know, I'll see. That might be more work than I want to do, but at least I'm going to try to darken this case besides what's going on underneath the dial with the dial and the handsets. And before I get to the staining, I might just get rid of all this, at least this part of the polish, and on this side as well. The back doesn't matter to me, I'll leave that. I don't want to bother trying to brush something you won't see that much anyways. And just to give it more utilitarian look before I try to darken it. And I guess I'll do the same to the link sides. And what about this? I guess I should try to give it as much as a brush finish all the way through. I mean, this will look good on the strap as well and a NATO, but I do plan to use the bracelet still. So I will probably do a quick Scotch-Brite on these sides. And what else is there? The movement. This uses an unusual 23. Well, I would say that it's non-hacking, automatic, and non-hand winding movement, like an S7S26 that you find in most other Seiko 5s and the SKX, as well as some other Seikos, right, that have that older movement. But this is a 7S. See this 7S. It's kind of small, but this says 7S36. I think it says that on the back here too. 7S36, somewhere on here. And this is unusual. Yeah, it's right in there. And the movement is it's pretty much identical. I've looked this up, and the only difference seems to be there's two extra jewels. They said it's non-functioning, but I don't know why they would put it in there if it doesn't serve any purpose. But as far as everyone's chimed in, there's no real advantage to it. You don't get higher power reserve, nor more accurate movement or anything like that. It's just for some reason they decided to make us 7.36 with an extra 2 jewel movements. Just look it up online. That's a piece that, I don't know, it goes somewhere in here. It's like a part of a plate, extra plate that's in there. I think it's part of the balance bridge or something. I'm not a watch person. I mean, well, I am, but I mean, I don't know technically what all the parts are, but it's somewhere in there. But unfortunately, this watch came to me new. The movement doesn't work. I mean, I shook it a couple of times, and at best, maybe the second, isn't it kind of moved? Or maybe it's because of my motion. It doesn't really sustain any power. See, it moved a little, but I think it could be just from me or slightly from, it may pick up some of this and send the power to it, but it's not really getting in there. So, I mean, I contacted them and I could return this and probably get another one, but I kind of don't want to bother with that. I really should, because, you know, who wants to get a watch with it that doesn't even work? But I was researching some stuff online, and I think, I mean, I can't do any harm to it anyways, but I'm thinking I might be able to tinker with this and get it to work. I've never tried that before, but I think I might. Let me see if I can brighten this up a little bit too. In here, I mean, I was just comparing this to, I have an extra 7S26 movement, so I can just swap it in. I mean, I gotta change the dial and the hands anyways, but then if I do that, I'm gonna need the black day and date here to go into this extra one from a Seiko. You can see it in there. I'm a Seiko SKX. That works. I know that because I had it before. But so I could always swap it if I can't tinker with this enough to get it to work. By no means am I a watchmaker, but just looking at some of the photos, I mean, some things didn't look right. Like right here, this magic lever, this part of it, as you can see in there, this is part of the magic lever system. And you wind it, it does this thing with this arm that kind of, it's like a fork. And it kind of goes out here, and it goes out on the other side of this piece here, and it helps, either way you move it, it helps to wind and give power to the mainspring, I guess, or where the energy stored, it just helps wind it up. And what I've noticed is that piece on, there's that one of the arms here, that looks normal, but from what I've seen, this side looks different. You see how, I don't know where the tip of my finger is, that's the other part of this arm. And what I've seen in the pictures, it doesn't look like it's in the right position, and it's too close to this, whether this piece is, this gear, this cog, is right in here. You see that right in there, that little piece, you can see it peeking through, that's part of this arm, like on the other side, you know, it comes out this way. And this looks too close. And I'll do a quick comparison here and show you that on the 7S26, right in that same area. I mean, it should make a difference, but see this? Look at that. It's got some space from there. I don't have something to point with it. Do I have a little pointer tool? Let me just set this. Right in here is what I'm talking about. So here's part of that magic lever system. And you wind this moves, and then it causes this part to see. Right? And no matter what I do, It actually help. It moves this arm and it moves this bit here. I think you see it kind of start moving or winding. But the point is, this arm right in here, see there's some space from there. And see, just look at the relationship right here. And this arm is, you can clearly see it's out here. You know, that this, like, all around it is open. And it's kind of near this little screw thing. I should really keep this. I don't know, I'm trying to keep this movement clean. And put this back. And if you look on this guy here, let's see, where is it? Right here. Actually, it's over on this side. Damn it, I just have to undo this. I don't know if you can tell. Look, see how much closer this is to here? I don't know, it doesn't look like it's in the right position. That one looks like it was out like somewhere here, and then kind of. This is like the angle of this is pointing out past, you know, this little screw thing here, the center of this wheel, whatever you want to call it, this gear. And the other one is more, it's outer, and it was pointing more in towards the center of this part. So yeah, I think maybe it's something to do with this magic lever system. I don't know, maybe it's somehow weird and it got stuck under here. I don't know. I'm gonna toy with this and see what I can do. Yeah, I mean, I got nothing to lose, really. In fact, I gotta wrap this up and get some other stuff done. But turn this down because it's bright as heck. But what I'm gonna do is, yeah, I'm gonna just crack this open and just play around with this while I'm waiting for the parts anyways, and at least for the piece to arrive to a so the mod components to arrive. I just might as well play around with this and see if there's any way I can work my own magic to get this working. Because, yeah, it doesn't hold the charge and the balance wheel doesn't move anymore. Yeah. I don't know, we'll see. You know, the right thing to do would have been just to have them replace this watch, but I'm kind of lazy and on a time crunch to want to start this project, and I want to wait for another component to come back in, so I might just tinker with this. Worst case scenario, switch it to the 7S26 movement and proceed. So that's about it. I guess I'm gonna put this down here, and yeah, if I haven't flashed a photo of what I'm planning to do, what it will look like with the parts, I'll do it here, but I'll probably feed it somewhere in the beginning of this video. Anyways, that's it for now. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for more on this build mod. All right, later.